accurate documentation promotes sound management of the collection and facilitates the use of and access to the collection. Heritage institutions have two responsibilities that make the documentation of collections important: responsible collection control and the interpretation and communication of knowledge. Responsible collection control requires the identification, management, and preservation of collections. Interpretation and communication of knowledge requires access to information and access to collection objects. When undertaking a collection documentation project, you must determine the most appropriate method: basic inventory or cataloging. Each method has its own purpose and requirements. A basic inventory will identify what is in the collection, tell you how many items there are, and identify where each item can be found. At the very least, institutions should have such an inventory of their collections in order to fulfill their mandates with respect to the management of public collections. However, this basic information is quite often too limited for the collections to be properly understood and promoted. Which brings us to cataloging. Beyond the basic inventory information, museums will need to do some additional documentation or cataloging of the collection. Some of the information is intrinsic, meaning the physical characteristics of the object. On the other hand, some of the information is extrinsic, meaning the context and history of the object. Sometimes, both physical and contextual information is collected and recorded at the same time. Physical or intrinsic information can be deduced by an examination of the item itself. It may consist of the materials of which the object is made and the technique used to make it, the object's size or dimensions, the object's decorative motifs, inscriptions found on the object, or the condition of the object. The process of documenting the intrinsic information, which provides more detailed physical descriptions of the objects, allows us to better understand the collections, anticipate storage and preservation needs more precisely, and obtain photographs of the objects. Contextual or extrinsic information can be derived from investigation and research. It may consist of the history of the object, for example, who owned it, how was it used, or what has happened to it since being acquired by the museum, where and when it was created or manufactured, who created it, or what was the cultural context in which it was created or used. The advantage of cataloging the extrinsic information is that it provides much more detailed information on the collections and thus fosters both efficient management and in-depth knowledge of the collections. It also requires a significant investment in both time and resources to do this type of cataloging. So sometimes museums reserve this type of in-depth contextual research for objects that are considered major pieces of the collection. Basic inventory is essential. But how much documentation is required beyond that? The nature and quantity of the information collected during a collections documentation process must be based on the desired objectives and goals of the documentation process being carried out, the nature of the collection, the accessibility and reliability of the information already available, and the resources that we have at our disposal to carry out the work. We have seen how adequate documentation enables sound management of and access to the museum collection. We have also reviewed the main methods used for collections documentation. Thank you for watching. Be sure to keep an eye out for other videos in this series that will introduce the various types of standards used for museum documentation and provide advice on planning a collection development project.